So this is a question from an Instagram follower in the DMs, and he says, "Hi, I have a question regarding the numbering in the electric circuits. I don't think English is his first language. Are there principles and techniques to be adopted, and how can it be mastered?" What he's also sent me a photo here. Not sure if you can see it. Basically, what he's saying is the numbering on cables, I don't know if he's asking generally or just specifically on this photo, for cables going into terminal blocks, what are the principles around the numbering of them? You know, is there any patterns? So I'm going to record an audio note and get back to him. Hi, mate. So to me, it doesn't really matter. People adopt different strategies for doing this. One simple strategy just might be from one up to whatever number you get to, as long as they're different. You could adopt a strategy where you're keeping all the cables on page one of your designs, starting with one. Page two, all of them start with a two. Page three, they all start with a three, and so on and so forth. And what the guys that I do a lot of contracting for do is they have like numbers associated with different points in the circuit. So control circuits all start with a one, terminal blocks all start with a six, and that's all I can remember at the moment. But yeah, hopefully that helps. But really, it doesn't really matter. As long as it matches your documentation, it doesn't matter. So this is a question from, they're based in the UK. So it's an electrical firm based in the UK. And they are asking, how do you rate Loxone to Control4? We are C4 dealers, so Control4 dealers, but considering Loxone training at the moment. Any input appreciated? How's it going, mate? Yeah, so how I differentiate the two. So Control4 is a really good system for anything AV related, really quick and easy to program if you're doing anything with TVs, audio matrix, video matrixes, however they're pronounced. And just sort of like audio visual integration. Also, you can bring in things like security, CCTV cameras, all of that. And of course, as I'm sure you know, you can do lighting and heating and all the rest of it. But when you come to do, I'll start a new message. But what I found, when you try and use it for higher end buildings where you want to do proper sort of BMS and HVAC control, then this is where Loxone is a much better system, and designed in a way to quickly install and quickly program, you know, home automation or BMS systems. So it's not so good on the AV side, Loxone. But in terms of like having a good sort of building management system, controlling all the lighting, heating, security, blinds, multi-room audio, access, and that sort of thing, it's really good and it's really quick to do it with Loxone. Also with Loxone, it's kind of it's an interesting system because they refer to it as Clopen. It's kind of like a mix of Apple and Linux. So you've got the closed proprietary side using all the Loxone technology like Tree and Air and keeping it all within the Loxone ecosystem, which again, that is even quicker to do things that way. But you're obviously tied into all of their hardware and whatnot. But it's also open to use standard electrical controls using inputs and outputs and using other field devices. So yeah, it's a good system to use sort of in both ways, really, however you want to use it. Like, for example, if you were just doing like a mid mid-tier home, and they weren't interested in anything to do with AV. They weren't interested in a cinema room. They quite liked the Loxone user interface and the switches and some of the other peripherals like the motion sensors. Like, it would be a really good system to use if you wanted to do it quickly and sort of hand it over and not worry about going really in depth into the programming, because a lot of the programming, for example, like someone rings the doorbell and you want the lights to flash, or it's a turn off your audio and play a chime through your multi-room audio, all of that's kind of pre-programmed within Loxone. So yeah, it's really nice and quick to use it in that sense.